Good morning, everyone. All of us have been to birthday parties, right? Well, today we all are here for a similar cause.
Wait, is this a birthday celebration of some person?
Certainly, yes.
Then who is this special personality?
Not a person really, but this is the birth anniversary celebration of our very beloved school, the Anubhuti International. Today marks the beginning of its 14th year, and since 7th July 2007, this school and its associates have seen many overwhelming developments, and today, we using this virtual platform, we celebrate all of that.
Wow, this is really a very unique way to celebrate something. And therefore, here I am Ashlesha Yavalkar, along with my co-anchor Ansh Patni. And today, we will be revisiting the most pleasurable times of our school. Times when we felt proud of as an Anubhuti. Times when Anubhuti School received the Green School Award and when it was registered as one of the great places to study in India.
Yes, Ashlesha. I am pretty sure that everyone present in the room would be agreeing to your words. Why not? This place is indeed the one which captures all our memories and opportunities which we can hold back to in our entire life. When our Dadaji first saw this barren land, only he could see how beautiful this place will turn out to be. For everyone, it seemed an arid land. But who knew that our Dadaji would turn this place into a marvelous location for studying?
Yes, very true, Ansh. Is Harshal sir there with us?
Yes. Yes, sir.
Should we start, sir?
Yeah.
Okay. So without wasting any more time, let's quickly begin with the celebration for the day. I heartily welcome our respected Atul Bhau, Nisha Akka, Parmar sir, JP Rao sir, beloved teachers and all our dear friends.
Throughout this ceremony, we will witness a lot of beautiful dances, intriguing poems, melodious songs, a callback message from our alumni, and some very special video messages. However, as an audience, all you have to do is to sit back, enjoy, and recollect all your Anubhuti memories. Like every other function in our school, let us now remember Ganesh ji before beginning with anything. I request Nikhil sir to please present the Gaiye Ganpati Bhajan and get us all engrossed in the highfall rhythm. With this, I also invite JP Rao sir and Parmar sir for the lighting of lamp.
Gaiye Ganapati Shankara Puranam Bhavani
Thank you, everyone. As we all know that JP Rao sir is one of the oldest associates of this very beautiful school. He has been through all the ups and downs that our school has seen. Therefore, hearing it from him would be the perfect idea. Let's welcome respected JP Rao sir to tell us more stories about this beautiful place.
Okay. Good morning, everybody.
Morning, sir.
Good morning, sir. Good morning.
Good morning.
Good morning.
This is the birthday of our school, and therefore, you know, it should not be a very, very solemn occasion. It's a very happy occasion, right? Well, we are celebrating the birth anniversary of Anubhuti School. In fact, the school started on the auspicious day of 7/7/7. It's unfortunate that I was not part of that, and much later that I joined school. That's 2 years after that I joined school. That was in 2009. Today, we have finished 14 years of the existence of our school. The 15th year has started today. And it's a very, very happy thing, because the birth of a good school must be a celebration in the world of education, not just confined to the town of Jalgaon. Since we are a residential school, we have attracted students from several states. In fact, there is no boundary. And I think the best of the things are here for anybody to come and pursue their education. One of the best things that we can think of for this school is the statement of purpose that our beloved Dadaji has bestowed upon us. He has given it as a kind of a gift. It's a very, very rare thing. It's a very, very rare document. Not many schools have an SOP like this. And it very, very clearly tells you what exactly the school should be doing. And it is not confined only to the school, but it captures the essence of education. That is what one has to understand. We know for certain that learning, as the very word says, anubhuti, it is a learning that is based on how a human being experiences and learns through that experience. You know that in the ancient times, where there were no formal schools, they learned from observing. They learned from what their elders had done. All the skills that we have learned in the old times have all come down to us from our parents and our grandparents and all those people that went before us. And today, we know that the times have changed. The Industrial Revolution had done a great deal of, I would say, damage, but I'm sure many people don't agree with what I'm saying, that it has created schools of this type, where you have a curriculum, you have a syllabus, you have a test, you have examinations, and there is somebody to certify that you have your past class 10, your past, whatever, this degree, that degree. I don't think it's necessary. So one of the things that one has to understand, and understand what Dadaji has given to us, the statement of purpose. The purpose of this school is not merely to learn from your books, pass examinations and things like that. In fact, he also says very, very clearly, you be a good human being first, before you want to become this then. Right? Now, what does that mean? To be a good human being means to understand each other. Should be able to understand. Say, for example, as of today, I'm going to teach a few chapters of a few stories of The Merchant of Venice to class 10 students, where the principal theme is justice versus mercy. And it's one of the most beautiful things. And how does one understand this? Through books we can understand, but then the understanding must happen in a very, very, very different way. And that can happen through experience, right? Dadaji, in giving this kind of a dictum to this school, is trying to tell us, look, this place has to be given to those people, not only the teachers that come here, but also the students, those who come here. That very essence to pursue education. That word pursuit does not necessarily say that we should only learn it through books. No, certainly not. Through experience. That's why he even called the school Anubhuti. That has a very, very special significance. And in the years that went by, we have done pretty well, I must say. But we did have we had both ups and downs. And our first batch of class 10 was in 2011. And then we went ahead to get class 11, class 12 affiliation. And we had inspectors, everybody who had come here, worked very, very hard. And then in 2013, we had the first batch of class 12 students, ISE. Okay, now we have sent 8 batches of class 12. The last 2 years have been very traumatic, mainly because of the pandemic. While the children want to come here and study, which is what it is meant for, we don't see children here. There is no children, there are no children playing, there are no children quarreling amongst themselves, there are no children playing mischief. It's not there, but it's okay. I'm very, very sure all of you as students and parents, we are going through this struggle, and you must know that in the entire world, all through history, when human beings went through these difficulties, they came up with much better things to do. So I'm hoping that at the end of this pandemic, we as human beings who are struggling to grapple with this will have a new strength to create something much better. And human beings have always, always come up against such things, and then they have done a much better job. So I'm hoping that we'll all put our energies together and ensure that this school grows even bigger and much better, and then grows into one of the finest schools that anybody can think of anywhere in the world. I want to wish the school all the very best. Thank you very much.
Thank you so much, sir. Yes, this is a very happy occasion. And indeed, your words inspire us, motivate us every time. Ansh, you might be aware that adding cultural values to our lifestyle is one of the most important aspects of our personal development. Do you agree?
Very well said, Ashlesha. And it will not be wrong to say that Anubhuti has always respected cultural development and has also given us many opportunities to tell us through which we can add culture in our daily life.
Yes, and today we have one of our friends who will be here to show us a classical dance. And will certainly add more charm to our ceremony. Let's invite Anushka with her dance performance.
मन मंदिरा ते जाने ओ मन मंदिरा ते जाने उजड़ो न गे सादा का मन मंदिरा ते जाने उजड़ो न गे सादा का संवेदना Somewhere संवेदना संवादे सहवेदना बदाना मन मल्दिला ते जाने उजड़ो न गे सदका मन मल्दिला तड़हाताचारे शानी सहज सुखा का भोगी कुणी तड़हाता चारे शानी सहज सुखा का भोगी कुणी स्वयं प्रकाशी तू तारा चैतन्याचा गाभारा भर पंखातून स्वप्न उद्याचे भर पंखातून स्वप्न उद्याचे झेप घेरे पाखरा उजळून गे सदगा मन मल्दिरा दे जाने उजळून गे सदगा मन मल्दिरा मन मल्दिरा मन
Thank you, Anushka. Your dance move really engrossed us into the rhythmic zone, which was exactly what we needed. Moving on, as we all know, Anubhuti follows a long way from its foundation. Since its commencement, many students have experienced a major part of their lives in Anubhuti. And hence, it is certain that Anubhuti is more than just a school. To throw some more light on the same impression, let's invite one of our alumni, Tushar Kukreja. He is the part of the very first batch of Anubhuti School and is here to tell us about his journey in Anubhuti.
Hi, I'm Tushar Kukreja from the Golden Batch and recording this small video for the 14th anniversary of our Anubhuti School. In this 14 long years along with the school, our batch has also grown up and wedding bells have already rung for many. I have a deep emotional connect with the school, especially because some of my closest friends have been from Anubhuti. And whenever we meet, we recall, revisit those childhood days, and it's our absolute favorite pastime. During the school days, I was sincere, hardworking, and studied well. But along with the studies, I also participated in a lot of activities like Hindustani classical music, Kathak, other forms of dance, theatre, debate, and various other stage shows. And this has been the best part of my childhood days. In fact, even today, in my professional life, I draw a lot of confidence from these childhood experiences. So I also want to convey this to the present students at Anubhuti that be active and participate in a lot of co-curricular activities. Develop yourself holistically and see, narrow down your interest and see what really passionates you. School days, childhood days, especially at Anubhuti, this is the best time to identify yourself and understand who you really are. Because in future, you may not get all these facilities under single roof. And also, you may not get the time to explore. Experiential learning at Anubhuti instilled the value of love and empathy within me. I somewhere feel that the college life, the college curriculum may have given me the professional skills, but my values were instilled at Anubhuti. The value of compassion was ingrained in me during my childhood days at the school, and I am forever grateful for it. Remembering our beloved Dadaji and sending lots of love wishes to everyone at school and to all those who have been part of this beautiful journey. Thank you.
Thank you so much, Tushar Bhaiya. Indeed, your words really helped us to think what our life after Anubhuti will be and how Anubhuti will always reside in our hearts. Moving on, Ashlesha, I heard that you have danced on many occasions of our school, haven't you?
Yes, Ansh, I have.
So why stay behind today? It's our school's birthday. Come on, you should have the same spirit as Anushka.
Yeah, I think that would be a really nice idea. Let's do it. But Ansh, I will really need a partner.
Ashlesha, I think I can join you.
Wow, great. This would be perfect. Everyone, let's invite Ananya and Ashlesha for a cheerful dance.
छोड़ा है जहान नीच मैं तुम्हारे अब हूँ हवाले अब दूर दूर लोग बाग मिलो दूर ये वादियाँ फिर धुआं धुआं तलहर बदली चली आती है छूने पर कोई बदली कभी कहीं कर दे तनगीला ये भी ना हो मंजर पर मैं रुका नहीं कभी खुद से भी मैं मिला नहीं ये किला तो है मैं खफा नहीं शहर एक से गांव एक से लोग एक से नाम एक ओ, 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 ओ फिर से उड़ चला पिट्टी जैसे सपने ये किताबी पलकों से झाड़ो फिर आ जाते इतने सारे सपने क्या कहूँ किस तरह से मैंने तोड़े हैं छोड़े मेरे साथ चले मुझे लेके उड़े ये क्यों
थैंक यू अश्लेषा एंड अनन्या
अंश I'm pretty sure that you, along with everyone in this room, would believe that this auspicious day isn't complete without Atul Bhau addressing us. He has been with Dadaji when the school was just an idea. And till date, he is implementing Bade Bhau's values within us. He follows the same path as Dadaji wanted us to follow. Therefore, without wasting any time, let us invite Atul Bhau to inspire us with his words.
A very good morning to all. I don't know if I'm audible, but...
Yes, sir.
All right. So, good morning to all. I hope this special day finds you in a very good health and cheer. More particularly because of the pandemic, you know, that's hovering around our head and has obviously caused a great amount of turmoil in our life. But... you know, as I said, this is a very special and important day, you know, for all of you as well as for all the alumni and and all the mentors, teachers, and everybody who have been great contributor, the parents, you know, the great contributor in terms of building this institute so far. I'm very delighted and happy at the same time that you know, Anubhuti as a school is taking the shape as Dadaji would have had envisaged and has had always a dreamt of. And all credit goes to all the alumni as well as all you students who have been currently at the school, as well as I said, all the teachers, the mentors, and all the you know, Dadas and all the administration staff and everybody who has been a very integral part of this institute so far. Particularly, I'm also very glad the way we have evolved ourselves over the period of last 14 years. But I believe this is an institute which is here to stay for centuries together, and this is just the beginning of a lot of great things that Anubhuti you know, will continue to offer in shaping up the lives of the young and budding you know, children like yourself, the students like yourself, and in a manner they would evolve in a manner that they would make a difference to this world, to make this a better place to live in than what they found. And I think Dadaji would be the most happiest person when he sees that happening, because that is what exactly he had in mind while he dreamt and you know, thought about starting Anubhuti. I'm sure this is a difficult time all of us are going through, more particularly students, because you know, this is one of important times of your life to be at school. And unfortunately, with whatever worth it is, you know, we have not been able to start the school at its full scale. We tried, we did that for a couple of months last year, but this year so far, we have not been given permission to start. In fact, I'm very hopeful and looking forward for certain communication and approvals coming from the government so that we can start the school at the earliest. And I'm sure all of you are very eagerly waiting for that to happen, and so are we, and so are, I'm sure, all the teachers and mentors. So on this special day, once again, I wish you a wonderful year ahead, you know, in spite of the difficulties. But at the same time, I would also like all of us, all of you, particularly the students, to, you know, I mean, as there's always a blessing in disguise, and disguise is that you have not been able to be at school, but at the same time, it had given us an opportunity, a platform to learn so many new things in our life, which otherwise probably would not, because you have, in a sense, a good amount of spare time on our hand now to learn more skills, to learn more things in life, to make ourselves a better person. So please do that. Continue to be focused on your studies. Continue to be focused on building your personality. And continue to also be very careful and spread the right and good message about pandemic and the care to be taken, precautions to be taken to make sure that, you know, we keep the you know, coronavirus at bay and protect ourselves, protect our families, and in turn protect the nation. While we do that, I'm sure you know, I know as much as you are all very eager to look forward for everyone getting your own vaccinations done, but till the time that comes around, I think you could also be those torchbearer of making sure that, you know, all the elders who are allowed to and who can take their vaccination, I'm sure you would do a you know, appropriate communication with all of them in terms of making sure that all your near dear ones who can, who are eligible to take the vaccination, have taken that. So please do that. And as I said, you know, enjoy this year ahead, you know, in best possible manner. And I pray and look forward for your presence at the school at the earliest. So thank you very much for this opportunity. And I wish all of you a great, you know, sort of a birthday for the school, and as well as in term, all the contributor, all the pillars, and you know, who have been part and parcel of it, should also take that as their birthday today. So thank you so very much, and have a wonderful year ahead.
Thank you, Atul Bhau. I am sure everyone would indeed agree to your statement that this institution is here to stay and will continue to give us many budding children and you know, successful people. Moving on, I'm also sure that all that you have told today will be instilled in our hearts forever, and we promise to follow this lead all through our life.
Yes, thank you very much. Thank you, sir. Poems are a beautiful way to express your thoughts into words without any restrictions. And so, we have a young poet with us who is here to inspire us using his rhythmic poem. Let's welcome Akshat with his poem.
मेरा सुलझेटा कक्षा छः मेरा स्कूल कविता मेरा स्कूल मैं कितना सुंदर जैसे फूल मेरा स्कूल कैसे जाऊं इसे भूल स्कूल के शिक्षक जितने सारे मार्गदर्शक सभी हमारे मेरे स्कूल से ना कोई दूर जा होती सरस्वती की पूजा मेरा स्कूल दिखने में है खूबसूरत जिसकी हमको बड़ी जरूरत पुस्तकालय वो भंडार जहाँ किताबों की भरमार मेरा स्कूल लंबे चौड़े हैं मैदान जिससे हमको है अभिमान याद आएंगे स्कूल के दिन जब हम होंगे इसके बिन यहाँ पे पढ़ना लिखना सीखा अनुशासन और तरीका मेरा स्कूल है पवित्र यहाँ की धूल मेरा स्कूल कितना सुंदर जैसे फूल मेरा स्कूल कैसे जाऊँ इसे भूल धन्यवाद
थैंक यू अक्षत Now, it is time to call back one of our alumni again. This person was the very first Anubhutian who stayed with school all along from a fifth class to the final year of a high school. I think this fact already excites us to hear about experience, right? Therefore, to call us, to tell us that even if you pass out for Anubhuti, you will stay connected to it throughout your memories. I welcome Dr. Sheetal Shinde.
Hi, a very good morning to my respected teachers and my dear students in Anubhuti. So today I'm going to relish the best days of my life. Hi, I'm Dr. Shivani Shinde, and my journey in Anubhuti began in 2007. And I can't deny and I must say that those were the best years of my life. Anubhuti is like a second home to us. Not a day goes by when we are not reminded of Anubhuti. It has played a very vital role in nurturing us into good human beings. And of course, this wouldn't have been possible without my very brilliant and warm teachers and our dear Dadaji. We absolutely miss all the Sundays spent with Dadaji. Learning in Anubhuti was always fun. Our classes, our assemblies, our outings were always exciting and never dull. Out of many qualities, one essential quality that Anubhuti and my teachers have helped me imbibe in myself is self-discipline. Self-discipline made the process of achieving and accomplishing goals very easy. And this very quality has helped me throughout the years of my MBBS. And I'm sure our present students in Anubhuti are having fun and learning and having the best days of their lives. All the best to you guys. Take care, be safe. And a very happy birthday to my dear Anubhuti.
Hi.
Thank you, Dr. Shivani. I'm sure that everyone was happy when we heard that Anubhuti stays in our hearts forever, even if we pass out of it. Now we request all of you to get ready for the next delight of the day, as I invite two of the most skilled dancers that our school has witnessed. Presenting to you the dance performance of this very talented duo, Kashish Erawar and Urvesha Naughare.
फिक्री जो थी पीछे रह गई, निकले उनसे आगे हम। हवा में बह रही है जिंदगी, ये हमसे कह रही है जिंदगी। ओहो अब तो जो भी हो सो।
And Kashish, this was indeed a very graceful dance performance. Like dance, music is yet another very interesting source of entertainment. We all love to sing our favorite songs. Some of us even end up choosing it our mainstream career. So to find our next singing sensation, let's invite the very talented choir group of Anubhuti School, who is here with a very delightful song.
Make a better world. Heal the world.
Thank you, choir group, for this very motivating and melodic performance. Throughout the song, I could remember one of Dadaji's thought, which was to leave the world better than we found it. And since we are in the musical zone already, I think that this would be the perfect time to invite one of our another very sensational singer, Prapti. And she's here to rejoice us with the help of her melodic voice. Please welcome Prapti and her beautiful song.
इतनी शक्ति हमें दे ना दाता, मन का विश्वास कमजोर हो ना। इतनी शक्ति हमें दे ना दाता, मन का विश्वास कमजोर हो ना। हम चलेने का रास्ते पे हमसे भूल कर भी कोई भूल हो ना। इतनी शक्ति हमें दे न दाता, मन का विश्वास कमजोर हो ना। दूर अज्ञान के हो अंधेरे, तू हमें ज्ञान की रोशनी दे। हर बुराई से बचते रहे हम, जितनी भी दे भली जिंदगी में। बैर होना किसी का किसी से, भावना मन में बदले की होना। हम चले नेक रास्ते पे हमसे, भूल कर भी कोई भूल हो ना। इतनी शक्ति हमें दे ना दाता, मन का विश्वास कमजोर हो ना।
थैंक यू प्राप्ति. अश्लेषा, do you know that every year on our school's birth anniversary, we have our senior most students of the 12th batch who are associated with Anubhuti since the very beginning, that is the 5th class. These students literally grow up in Anubhuti's environment from their childhood. Don't you think that they will have some pretty amazing stuff to share with all of us?
Yes, that would be interesting.
I know, right? So now let's call the oldest student present in the room. They are Karan Jashnani, Kashish Yeravar, and Bhavesh Dalmia. Firstly, let's hear it from Karan.
Well, thank you, Ansh. So, indeed, it's true when they say that there's no turning back when you love something good. Good morning, everyone. I am Karan Jashnani, and I feel the hospitality when I say that I am part of this family from the fifth grade. I felt those words which I said in the beginning, because I love this family and the place. And the thought of leaving it never occupied my head. At the age of 9, I entered this place and started to cherish every moment of it. The substitute classes where J.P. Rao sir would tell us stories while we sat in the corner. The exciting organic farming plus astronomical sessions and tours with Parmar sir till 8th grade, which were pretty awesome. The language class, which didn't only feel like language classes, but felt more like a combo package of public speaking, enduring the skills and the time of Abhinav sir. 8 years never felt like 8 years because it became part of my life. Anubhuti school became part of my life. Its schedule became part of my life. The dadas, tais, akka, guruma, and sirs. I mean, I don't even know sirs is right or not, the pronunciation or grammatically, but well, I remember how nicely our male teachers gave us competition in sports and how our akkas helped us to organize program. Well, Harshil sir, you are an exception. So while driving down to the end of this little gesture, I would like to just say, there's no praising about this school that can be proved wrong, except the in-campus swimming pool. Parmar sir, we really do need a swimming pool in the school. Thank you, everyone. I love this place and the people here.
Thank you, Karan. And indeed, we all felt the words which you said in the starting, that this place is more than just a school and it is a family for all of us. Moving on, let's have the second personality, Kashish Yeravar.
Good morning, everyone. Happy birthday, Anubhuti School. It is rightly quoted or said that what makes a child gifted and talented may not always be good grades in school, but a different way of looking at the world and learning. Anubhuti witnesses to be that spectacle for each and every child, eventually giving them a new perspective of looking at the world. According to dictionary, school is just a mere formal institution for imparting knowledge. But for me, the word school carries a complete different meaning. Anubhuti for me has always been that magnificent place, a place where nothing is constricted, where every person stays connected, where the environment is so welcoming, where every tree induces a different kind of freshness within us, and where every person shares immense amount of love. My mysterious journey started as a small bubbling kid who had never really seen the outside world, but was suddenly put into this world that felt known but was anonymous. On this 14th birthday, I just want to acknowledge this wonderful place and people who made this place and my journey so memorable and wonderful. At last, all I want to say is that this place will always have a great significance in my life because this was the place that shared and gave me the best moments of my life. Thank you so much.
Thank you, Kashish. This place is more than just an institution, correctly said. Moving on, let's have the last student from our batch, that is Bhavesh Dalmia.
The place where I spent 8 years of my life has its birthday to me. The journey of Anubhuti started for me when I was 10 years old. First day, the school was interview, which was a hectic job for me, because I was scared and was not ready that what question they will ask and I will know that or not. But as the interview started, it was not a tough job for me and I cleared it. Now it was time for me to leave the family and home and come and settle in the school. At first, I was ready to go to school, but when I reached school, I was crying and I was not ready to go to school. But and my parents convinced me and I was ready to go to school. I started to study and made new friends there and started to follow the school's rules. It was fun for me to study and play there. I was happy and was enjoying the school. The food was a big challenge for me as we had to eat all the things that were served in our plate. But as the days passed by, I liked it and ate everything. When I joined, I did not plan to study this long, but as the days passed by and settled in the school and it extended, there was fun when we used to eat illegal tuck in the nights hiding from our house parents. I will miss all the programs and the late night plannings that we used to do for the programs. It was all fun. I think that we are in a such a good place and we want to go out. And when we go out, we think that and remember about Anubhuti that we should go back in Anubhuti. It was such a safe and a secure place. When we are having something, we do not know the importance of that thing. But when we lose that thing, we start to remember the importance of the thing. I will miss all the things which I did in Anubhuti school and will thank Anubhuti school for making me such a person who can be independent in his life.
Thank you so much, you all. Your words really navigated us back in time, and in a way we all experienced them very closely as well. Ansh, I feel that being the most senior batch, it is our responsibility as well to bid and contribute something to this birth anniversary celebration. Therefore, now we invite the whole VSPAN team with a very special video message, which I am sure will leave you in nostalgia.
They say you come a year closer to death on your birthday. There's less of this time to explore the world, jam up with people, ride through cities, touch the heart.
But a school that crosses a year's benchmark, it comes that much closer to immortality.
people may wonder how a mere place built out of bricks and cement would come to live in a person so much so that the place is rendered immortal. But then that's exactly what a school does to a student.
It's made of buildings. No. Of teachers. No. Of students. Hell no. But a school is made of teachers, students, and the buildings all together. Yes and yes.
You know, in this meeting, apart from you and me, students and teachers who aren't really there, it's the gazebo, the tree point, the library, and whatnot.
Today, at the start of the 14th year of the school, we have recollected all the memories from high to low and compiled them into a recaptivating video. A happy cheers to all the bittersweet experiences, to the every bit of the school.
Cheers to the assembly hall's podium. We rubbed our sweaty hands on folded mats that we would run away from and then run to when finally spread by some angel. Noisy but heart-beating havoc when it's Friday. And one need not tell next.
This is to the library that was so well organized, it never made us left out. We always knew we have a hurricane of knowledge flooding us with whatever topic we laid our interest on. A world so deep, erudite, and tempting that one dies to dive in it, and that's why we call it Dhyan Anubhuti, which is completely different but yet an Anubhutian world.
Cheers to varied students having the knack of art sharing the same space. The one filled with wooden aroma from a fresh new tin of charcoal pencils, the pungent smell of acrylics, the exhilarating scent of stretched canvases, the perfectly imperfect masterpieces, no quantity of it all can completely suffice us. Cheers to the art block.
This one is for the gazebo. By that first it is intrigued by its name, but what it could do just to speedify our studies, to how it could make up itself a perfect place to just sit and chat.
Two places that filled our bellies, be it at the cost of queer looks on being able to persist it for extra sweet, or extra little Lilda in giving away atom you never liked. And in spite of spoonful of Loki ki sabji you had to stuff in at the last minute failure of sneak and run tight to our favorite place, dining hall.
Those 250 steps that took us to Kachoris. To those meetings with Bhav, to breezy winds and birds hag. To the meditation pond. Those steps would always stay more than just a path in our hearts.
As to the classes that were not so much formed of words as of windows, that we used to hurt quite a time the broken glass, but swept and decorated and made up tight, that housed our books in small shelves and gibbles in large air.
This goes to the dormitories or gyms we used for, what it shouldn't be used for, to the chats at home parents' place, to the food we savor at sleeping hours.
Remembering a day in Anubhuti without mentioning its most joyous time would be an injustice. These 2 hours are like blessing in disguise, wherein you play, run, stretch your bodies and sweat yourselves until your endurance answers you out. Without any doubt, this is a part of the day that should be cherished.
At Anubhuti, we are a family, enduring through time, merrymaking and learning. From forming ceramic pots, gushing through the admin block, overfilling those water bottles, that Saturday movie night, that Sunday special lunch, along with the special treat, from agitating students every Friday before the Anubhuti space.
A place where we first climbed our heights. A place where we first hit bottom rocks. And a place where we rose again like a phoenix from ashes. A place where we once felt homesick. And a place which then turned into a home. It is opulence. It is gold. It is Anubhuti.
Thank you, Team VSpan. This video really took us back to all the places where we have created so many memories. So far, we have seen how Anubhuti was born, some amazing dances, and what our alumni think about their life after Anubhuti. But remembering the visionary behind this school is still left. How can we forget our beloved Dadaji? I am sure most of us in this room, including me, didn't have the privilege to meet him in real life. Yet, we all want to follow his life lessons. Therefore, to enlighten us more about Dadaji's values and thoughts, let's invite Class 10 with a very special video.
Wow, for whom work was life and life was work. One man's desire to improve his fellow man spearheaded a revolution in sustainable agriculture that has transformed lives of millions of farmers, associates, stakeholders, and societies around the world. Every business of Jain's ensures that it creates shared value, nurture the environment, and contribute significantly in water and food security of the world.
Born in a farmer's household in Wakar, a village in Maharashtra, he belonged to a family whose origins lie in Rajasthan, carrying the roots of Jain heritage. After his initial education in Wakar and Jalgaon, he graduated in commerce and law from Mumbai University. He opted to become an entrepreneur to fulfill his mother's teaching.
Started with a small capital of rupees 7,000, total savings of 3 generations, acquired experience and knowledge of farming at the family's farm, commitment to his native land compelled him to make Jalgaon his headquarters for business. Built a successful enterprise with strong business acumen, hard work, risk-taking ability, and a sincere desire to help the farmers and family.
Pioneered micro-irrigation system for small farmers, Jain Irrigation, a publicly listed company of technology to save water and improve agricultural productivity. For value addition to agricultural procedures, started food processing to ensure quality, traceability, and sustainability, established a full-fledged agricultural and biotechnological R&D center.
Popularized tissue culture, banana plants increased yield and income of farmers. Built renewable energy sources for agricultural and non-agricultural applications. Establishing high-tech agricultural training institutes for knowledge transfer to small farmers. A charitable trust established in 1982. To promote education, health, sports, culture, religion, spiritual and social activities. Established a world-class residential school with emphasis of Indian cultural heritage, independence and entrepreneurial abilities. Establishing a fully funded English medium school providing quality education to no cost to children of the weakest members of society, enabling them with an opportunity to fulfill their dreams and excel in life.
Gandhi Research Foundation was started to help establish a world founded on truth, ahimsa, peaceful coexistence, conservation and love of living. Nurtured a joint family full of warmth and love, with mutual interdependence, care and empathy for each other. An ordinary man who did most extraordinary work.
He was a man of small ideas which created big revolution. He practiced what he preached and he built his entire business on the foundation of inclusiveness, sustainability over the last 5 decades. believe farmers are entrepreneurs who must get dignity as well as high income. He was a small town entrepreneur who established a billion-dollar multinational company.
Leave the world better than you found it. A promise he kept and the legacy he left for the organization and the future generation. Price instead of money, hard work instead of wealth, and responsibility instead of glory. He was a remarkable human being, a visionary, philanthropist, entrepreneur, and had a profound impact on the countless lives that he touched. Below are my five favorite quotes from the great man. A person who is passionate about achieving his goal never feels harassed or tired with their work. A beauty of life lies in taking challenges head on and transforming them into opportunities. A business based on the positive energy of love and labor is unparalleled. The generous and compassionate are the almighty embraces on the earth. A rough gem becomes a precious gem only after undergoing agony of cutting and polishing.
Your presentation definitely made us remember our Dadaji in his mission and vision behind this beautiful place. Although Dadaji is not with us, we all are connected to him in many different ways. One of them being listening to his favorite devotional songs. I remember once Atul Bhau told us that the Tera Mangal song was his most favorite devotional song. So why not invite the melodic choir once again to illuminate Dadaji's thoughts and morale for us with the help of this very motivating song.
Yeah.
Thank you once again, Choir Group. Moving on, I now feel privileged to invite our new principal of this school, Mr. Manoj Parmar sir. Parmar sir is also one of the oldest and experienced associates of our school. He has worked closely with Dadaji and is now contributing to his dream by being our principal. Without any more ado, let's call Parmar sir.
Good morning, all of you.
Good morning, sir.
So, Good morning. So, thank you. Thank you, everyone. Dear children, dear colleagues, admin staff, dining hall dadas, security department, everyone who are contributing this world, this Anubhuti world, making it beautiful. Every day we are polishing it. Every day we are evolving. See, evolution is a beautiful process. It is a tough process also. We have to drop something. We have to gain something. And that is called as the evolution. We have become humans from animals. Dadaji once said that it is not a short-term project. Anubhuti is a long-term project. Many people will come. Many intellectuals will be required. Many non-academic people will be required. Here, this place is a fertile place where we nurture talent. We find the element in you. You have born with some innate element. And throughout the life, we try to discover it. Who am I? What are my potentials? So the great educators of Anubhuti School, they help you in finding this. We ourselves are discovering ourselves. We ourselves are making us strong. We ourselves are evolving. So we teachers are your co-learners. We are learning together. Whenever I go to the class, I say that I am the senior most student of the class. After the class, you will be equal to me. It is a quantitative difference. Anubhuti School bothers about your character development, your mental development, your social development. Here, we are making creative minds. Here, we are making respectful minds. Here, we are making synthesizing minds. Our science and technology department teaching you to doubt. Our art department teaching you the beauty of life. The mathematics department teaching you the poetry of life. The language department is teaching you the beautiful language, the beautiful expressions. It is compulsory for everyone to participate. Why? Expression is very important. This school provides stage. This school provides platform so that you can express yourself. We tell every child to come and speak on stage, dance, okay, involve in art in department, play. Now, this is the biggest challenge in the new normal. What to do when the children are at home? Every day we are doing brainstorming sessions with teachers. We are thinking how to help children, how to help parents at home. We are doing activities, action-based program. Now, every day, art and craft department is doing something. Every day, our mathematics teachers, science teachers, language teachers, they are conducting lots of activities. Just by sitting on chair and learning will happen, we don't believe. That is the reason we are giving you some action-based projects also. Still, we are thinking about more and more projects which will help you to grow properly. Again, I'll say thank you to everyone. And thanks to this cultural team for organizing the wonderful program. And thanks to the children also. Okay, so thank you. Thank you.
Thank you, sir.
Thank you so much, Parmar sir. By listening your speech, we really recollected our classes we attended of yours when you said that you are the senior most student of our class. We are excited to see how we have evolved since the time we were born. We look at our childhood photographs and end up smiling. I'm pretty sure that the same will be the scenario when we will look at our school's development in the past years. Let's have a video showcasing then and now images of our school.
Thank you, technical team, for showing us this very beautiful video. We can see how Dadaji used to come every day to this site and examine whatever was happening very closely himself. And hence was the result. Within very few months, this school was made. And still today, it is standing on its feet very pridefully. And that is all the result of love and affection which Dadaji showed to this school while it was building. With this, we have come towards the end of today's celebration. I would like to thank Atul Bhau, Nisha Akka, Parmar sir, JP Rao sir, and the cultural committee who gave us this wonderful opportunity to present and celebrate the school's birthday together using the virtual platform. I would also like to specially thank Mahindra Dada, Mali Dada, Devi Das Dada, technical team, and Sandeep Dada, who were always at their feet whenever we needed their assistance. Also, I would like to thank our alumni, Mr. Tushar Kukreja and Dr. Sheetal Shinde, who were there, who are still connected to us and were able to express our thoughts to all of us. Also, thanks to the core group, that is Anushka Vatak, Mohit Giri, Shail Khirsagar, Yuvika Dhotwani, Shrija Mahato, Anushka Mahajan, and Samiksha Pawar, and all the participants for helping and making this celebration a success. Special mention to Team V-Span and Class 10 for their beautiful video messages. I remember how yesterday Hussain sir called this place a heaven on earth, and I'm sure everyone agrees to this statement. Indeed, this place is very beautiful, but due to the climatic changes and the current pandemic, we are not able to revisit our school. But I'm sure that in the coming days and the coming months, we'll be all together once again celebrating all the festivals and occasions together. For this, I urge and request all of you to please follow the pandemic measures and make sure that all your family members are vaccinated so that we fight this pandemic together and all together stop this pandemic from dislocating our lives anymore. And thank you everyone for joining. I think Nisha Akka has something to say.
Hello.
Yes, Akka.
Yes. Wonderful program. As usual, the class 12 team, class 11, 12 and whole team. I must say the whole Anubhutians, Anubhuti, all pillars, and the support staff, school, teachers and everyone. Really wonderful, wonderful job. And it is a nostalgia always, always. And when you see the Bahu has this paint, you have just seen the video, but I have witnessed it that every day and night Bahu was there. So it is our responsibility to keep up to his vision and make sure that the three pillars, SOPs will take it further, Indian culture, interdependence and entrepreneurship. And I think it is, everybody is committed to it. And one thing I would like to say here is, dear children, unwantedly, still you are there for very few years. Everyone who comes at 5th, 6th, 7th or 8th, and then they have to leave at 12th because there is no choice for you as well as for us. So make maximum of it. Make maximum use of the premises, may get maximum knowledge from this school and from teachers. Everybody is very lucky to have such, we have wonderful team of educators, wonderful team. Yes, you are really lucky and always encourage. I'm not saying only for the purpose of admission, because this school more like around 350-400 children. So through your contacts, please encourage other students also, so they also get the good knowledge and become a good citizen of India, because ultimately what India would look like is all in your hands, the majority in the young minds. And I can see very well through these alumni or I am in contact with. So every and each alumni are doing wonderfully well. And in all different areas, like some of them are very good musician already. Some of them are doctors, engineers, they are to there. And even if you are started their own startups, we will have the different session for that. And so who has already started the startups? Yeah, so which is amazing. So keep it up, right? And Ansh and Ashlesha, very good anchoring, very good, very good. And I'm proud of you, all my dear team, and proud of all Anubhutians and all Anubhuti team. Have a good day, celebrate, and celebrate every day as if our birthday. Yeah, okay. Thank you. Bye. Bye.
On this very positive note by Nisha Akka, I would like to conclude today's ceremony. Thank you for joining us. Hope you have a nice day.